Hey guys, this is Guije and JVB. Yeah.
Hello, everyone.
What's happening, guys? Thank you very much for tuning in to episode 26 of the Badges Podcast.
Yeah.
Unfortunately, JVB and I, you know, we have a lot of things left to do. You know, restringing Christmas lights. You know, cooking for the family, doing some Christmas shopping,
drinking lots of eggnog.
Course, making that Puerto Rican coquito.
Yeah,
some good stuff. You know, so we're unfortunately not going to be able to give you guys a full episode, which is kind of bad news, but actually good news in hindsight, right?
Yes, it is, because Blade and Stryker were kind enough to take over the realms for this episode. So, for the duration of episode 26, you're going to hear Blade and Stryker. And God only knows what they have in store for you.
So, without further ado, ladies and gentlemen, we want to wish you a Merry Christmas from the bottom of our hearts.
Yes.
We hope that your family is safe. You guys, all you good bad dudes and bad dudettes out there, we hope you get everything that you ask for. And, you know, remember, Christmas is about, it's about giving.
Yes, it is.
So, go ahead.
Yeah, do something nice. Be grateful. The New Year's is also around the corner, so every year is a blessing. So enjoy the holidays, enjoy the family time.
Yeah, and me and JVB, or sorry, JVB and myself, will see you guys at the beginning of the year.
Yes.
Until then, please be safe. Merry Christmas, and like I said before, without further ado, get ready for Blade and Stryker, and for the bad dudes. Christmas episode.
Merry Christmas.
It's the Bad Dudes Christmas special.
Beginning to look a lot like Christmas.
Featuring Blade.
Everywhere you go.
Stryker.
Take a look in the 5 and 10. Glistening once again with candy canes and silver lanes aglow. It's beginning to look a lot like Christmas.
Featuring the Bad Dudes family.
In every store. But the prettiest sight to see is the holly that will be on your own front door. A pair of hop-along boots and a pistol that shoots is the wish of Barney and Ben. Dolls that will talk and will go for a walk is the hope of Janice and Jen. And Mom and Dad can hardly wait for school to start again.
It's beginning to look a lot like Christmas everywhere you go.
There's a tree in the Grand Hotel, one in the park as well, the sturdy kind that doesn't mind the snow.
It's beginning to look a lot like Christmas.
Soon the bells will start, and the thing that'll make them ring is the carol that you sing right within your heart.
Beginning to look a lot like Christmas. Toys in every store.
But the prettiest sight to see is the holly that will be on your own front door.
Yeah.
For it's Christmas.
It's Christmas time, guys. Are you ready? Without further ado, you're Bad Dudes. Yes. It is beginning to look a lot like Christmas, right, Blade?
Yes, it is there, Stryker. What's going on, brother?
Nothing, man. I'm stoked. You know, it's the time of year where, you know, things just seem a little bit better, seem a little bit brighter. And I'm just really grateful to be sitting here next to you, brother, recording this special Christmas holiday episode of the Bad Dudes Podcast. It's been a minute since we got a chance to sit in the chair, bro.
Yes, it's been a long time. We're not on any missions. And Christmas always softens me up a little bit. It makes me smile. You know, I barely do that.
I even think it softens up even the worst of our villains. You know, they've been known once or twice to try to trickery dickery dock us and nickety knock the styles of the bad dudes.
Mm-hmm.
But you know, the Christmas spirit globally, the holiday spirit globally, seems to just make people just a little bit of that much nicer. And like I said, even the supervillains, you know, it seems like this time of year, they're just like, you know, even Skeletor's like,
you know, I was going to invade the Bad Dudes headquarters, but I think instead I'll sit at home with a cup of cocoa for my bones.
You kind of sound like him. It's a little scary almost.
Well, you know, I'm a
dropkick from hell.
I am a master of disguise.
Yes, you are. Remember the time you disguised yourself as Urkel from He-Man? And you went into Skeletor's lair and tricked
him? I do remember that. I was there.
Of course. You were him.
Yep. So,
but, the other day, I was speaking to Sal Triumphant, and he offered to make us his very own. I don't want to say the name, but he said he created his own tasty pie, and I had to refuse, brother, because we know what Sal Triumphant specializes in, and I really don't want to eat that for Christmas.
Oh my goodness. Robert, you know what though? How does Sal celebrate Christmas time?
Well, you know, he's always exercising. So first thing he does in Christmas morning, he throws away the cookies that he leaves out for Santa because he doesn't eat cookies. And then he does a million push-ups. He watches a little bit of Frosty the Snowman in the morning or something like that. And then he goes jogging again. Guy never stops working out.
That's awesome.
One time, as a matter of fact, he woke up and saw Santa coming down the chimney.
I hear that Sal Triumphant actually has to buy like 20 treadmills a year because he never stops exercising.
Mm-hmm.
He literally has to turn on a treadmill at night while he's sleeping because he jogs in his sleep.
Exactly. He's an unbelievable specimen.
Yep. I can't believe it.
What about, have you heard from Centurion? I'm a little worried about him. Last Christmas, we were a little tough on him. He did something to the eggnog, and I was really angry.
Well, so, you know, I love Centurion, too, but don't worry about him, because, you know, it is getting cold, and the bird part of Centurion always flies south for the winter.
Mm-hmm.
So right now he's kicking it in Miami, living La Vida Loca, and,
I heard he's a pelican now.
He's whatever he wants to be.
Mm-hmm.
You know, sometimes he's a flock of seagulls, and he runs so far away.
Yes.
He had to get away.
Mm-hmm.
How do you celebrate Christmas, my friend? I mean, before you were a bad dude, when you were just a little butter knife,
mm-hmm.
How did you celebrate Christmas?
Well, I used to wake up in anticipation, wondering what was under the tree. And sometimes I would, like most kids, try to open the paper without damaging it. Try to get a little sneak peek. But, you know, sometimes you open that sheet of paper and you see a gift you weren't expecting. And you might get disappointed. So I learned to welcome the element of surprise and appreciate it. So that's why now on the battlefield, I'm the ultimate warrior, not the wrestler. That guy trying to look like us failed big time. But I became the ultimate fighter. Well, not like the cage guys. Those guys are pretty weak. You know what I mean, though. I learned the element of surprise is always around the corner, brother. So that's how I learned. That's what I used to do during my early years as a butter knife.
Oh, man, when I was Gwee lowercase J.
Mm-hmm.
I mean, when I was Striker.
Yes.
With my friend, Gwee J.
Yes, that little guy.
I was with him, and we were just kicking it together on Christmas because we were neighbors.
Oh, cool.
We would just chill out with my uncle, Vosifus.
Mm-hmm.
And we would listen to these old, old Christmas tunes, and just, you know, grandma would be cooking up a beautiful turkey and a Christmas ham.
Yummy.
We would all bring presents. We didn't have much then. You know, we didn't have a lot of money.
Mm-hmm.
So, you know, we got little things, but it was the love that we had in our household.
Exactly, which is priceless.
And we used to just break it down and listen to some old, old Motown music.
Which one, brother?
Well, that's kind of like this.
La, 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 la. La, 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 la.
Smokey Robinson, have a super happy Christmas and a most successful coming year.
I really did see Mommy kissing Santa Claus.
Dashing through the snowman in a one-horse open sleigh. Oh, what fields we go.
Thank you.
That's a beautiful song, brother.
Yeah, you know, I met Mrs. Stryker during Christmas time. I don't know if you're aware of that. We actually got married during the Christmas season.
Wow.
Yeah. For those that don't know, it'll actually be our 11-year anniversary, December 18th.
You know what, brother? Me and my wife got married on December 18th, and we're going to be 11 years as well.
Oh, my goodness. Get out of town.
Yes.
Blade Brown.
Whoa. You know. That was a page from the Prez, but let me just let them know that we're recording.
Yeah. See if you want
there
to
we
send
go.
What does he say? Any holiday wishes for the Bad News listeners?
No, he just said that he couldn't find his teeth. Not bad, you know. Yeah, I have it, as a matter of fact. Around my neck. But anyway,
What?
I have his teeth around my neck like a necklace.
Why?
Reminds me of all the teeth I used to knock out from the ninjas.
Is he Chatty Cathy?
But since they're not around, I gotta use Ronnie's teeth.
Ah,
it's a mental thing, brother.
Hey, you do it, whatever helps you pass sleep through the night. You know what I mean? Mm-hmm. I'm not gonna... You know, you're a tomato, I'm a tomato. You're a... Conchito, I'm a Colito. It's all the same thing.
Oh, fooey.
But, yeah, so, you know, I remember one Christmas, you know, I really love Mrs. Stryker. She's, you know, she's a beautiful woman. She does a lot for me. She helps me out, and no one can suture a wound quite like she can.
Mm-hmm.
And, you know, we were out in a mission near... And, you know, she's like, you know, Stryker, I'm going to need you to pick up some peach glaze for the ham when you come back from the mission, you know?
Hmm.
And, you know, it was the one mission where we went to Kapurka, Turkestan to fight Alisha Mama Samba Shaka-san.
Yes, I hate that guy.
And, you know, of course, it was a regular mission. I mean, it was just covert ops. We were just finding out, you know, some secret plans to make a new hybrid ninja that actually had spring action toenails that would enable them to jump higher. But that never came into fruition because, you know, you remember we went in there, we snuck in, got the plans, and foiled the day. But regardless, I forgot to bring home the peach quiz.
And oh, man.
Just the look on her face was something that I will never forget because she counted on me, you know? She counted on me to really come through for her, and I ruined the Christmas ham.
You know? Oh, man, not the ham.
And, you know, and in the background, there was this song playing that, you know, even added to the fire, and every time I hear it, it reminds me of that one depressing Christmas I have. But it also, at the same time, reminds me of how much love I have for Mrs. Stryker.
Mm-hmm.
And if you have a loved one, especially during this time, you got to tell them that you love them. And it really, it's the little things in life. You know what I mean?
Exactly.
You know, like remembering guys, bad dudes, remembering, you know, bad dudes' fathers. You lift the toilet seat up when you're done using the bathroom.
Mm-hmm.
Or you put it down.
Put it down, brother.
You put it down. After you lift it up, you put it down.
Mm-hmm.
You know, it's remember to pick up your socks.
Yeah.
If they ask you to get peach glaze for the ham, just remember to do that. No matter how, you know, even, I was saving the world, and I should have remembered.
Mm-hmm. So, yes.
But, yeah.
You got to get the peach glaze. It's an integral part of the ham process.
Yeah. But, anyway, use that song, dude. Take a listen and tell me if you remember.
Okay.
Last Christmas. Sorry, brother. My eyes are a little sweaty there, brother, from listening to this song.
That's okay, dude, but like, it's a beautiful song. You know what I mean?
Being Wonder Woman, you know, kind of reminds me of Wonder Woman a little bit.
Yeah, how does your wife feel about Wonder Woman?
Well, she never wants me to speak to Wonder Woman again, so I can respect that, even though me and Wonder Woman are just friends. But yes, I too... Not R2. I, too, have great stories about that song. It's a very sad song, but you certainly remember...
The good times. You gotta remember the good times. Because, listen, I learned a lesson. And I think that's what important thing to remember as a bad dude. And we said this before, is that nobody's perfect. Exactly. The bad dudes will make mistakes. You'll make mistakes. But do we learn from them?
Absolutely, brother and sisters.
I never forgot the peach glaze ham again, I'll tell you that.
That's right, brother. And Centurion's never going to forget about the eggnog incident.
Nope, ever.
Neither will I.
Oh, come on. But that's not what Christmas is all about, man.
That's true. Just hurts. It's good eggnog.
Tell me, what is the meaning of Christmas to you, dude?
It is giving. It is family. It is love. And it is the most memorable moment you can ever imagine. Every Christmas brings new memories and more happiness than the last. To me, that's what Christmas is all about, brother.
You know what? I feel like, why? Why is Christmas time? Why is the spirit of Christmas only like one small segment out of the year? You know, like, as bad dudes... We're trying to spread the love, you know. We were trying to make the world a better place. We're trying to teach the boys and girls what's right, what's wrong. We're trying to help parents, you know, really help them get together and enjoy life together. But why are these attitudes of Christmas only last so often?
You know what I think it is, brother? Because people just have grown accustomed to being kind and being happy based on a holiday. When every day should be a holiday. It is a blessing to wake up. It is a blessing to look at your children and realize that you are lucky to have them around. And your loved ones, too.
That's true. That's true. You know, I am. I really am. I love it. I love to love.
And, no, man, it's all right,
no,
brother.
No, wait, I'm getting... soaking up the world love energy. It's too much for me.
So you're having an asthma attack.
No, I'm just... Me. Oh, wait.
What?
Logan X is here.
What's up, yo?
Logan.
Oh, my God. Logan X, what's happening, dude?
Nothing.
This is the Christmas episode.
Today, on the TV, on the Bad Dudes, I saw this movie called, Shrek the Final Chapter. It's really good, but on TV, this is, Broadway, Pack Ditch,
Logan!
Oh, yeah?
Logan! Logan!
Hey, Christmas
Logan.
Special.
Logan. What did you ask anything for Santa Claus this year?
Yes, yes, I did.
Why don't you tell the Bad News listeners what you do?
I asked Santa for everyone to have a good Christmas.
Oh, that's awesome. That's, you see, that's giving.
Mm-hmm.
That's
it.
That's great.
Why don't you wish the listeners a Merry Christmas before you leave, dude?
Huh?
Wish the listeners a Merry Christmas before you leave.
Merry Christmas, yo.
All right.
Merry Christmas, brother Logan.
All right, man. Keep doing what you're doing, dude. See, I'm telling you, that's what Christmas is all about. Logan X, just wanting everybody to have a Merry Christmas. That's what he wanted.
He just schooled everybody.
Yep. Just schooled everybody in a major way. And, you know, it's the meaning of Christmas, dude.
Mm-hmm.
It's the meaning of Christmas.
Meaning of Christmas.
Christmas is the time of year for being with the ones we love, sharing so much joy and cheer. What a wonderful feeling, watching the ones we love having so much fun. I was sitting by the fireside, taking a walk through the snow, listening to a children's choir, singing songs of my dreams. Blessed way that he came to offer us. Why can't it remain? Oh, all through the year, each day the same. Ah, that's what I want to get. It's truly amazing, that spirit of Christmas. that spirit of Christmas. Oh, it's truly amazing, that spirit of Christmas. Ain't it so? It's truly amazing. Yeah, that spirit of Christmas.
Oh, Christmas!
Oh,
Christmas!
Yeah, the spirit of Christmas.
It's awesome, brother. It's awesome. Yeah, so, you know, a lot of people associate the spirit of Christmas with the main man, homeboy number one.
Who, Santa?
Yeah,
that's my dog, brother.
Yeah, you know, a lot of people don't know Santa Claus is one of the original round table members of the Bad Dudes.
Yes, he's actually a bad dude himself.
Mm-hmm. He's a founding father. You know, the founding fathers of the Bad Dudes stem, you know, throughout history, and Santa Claus is, he's one of the men that sit at that table.
Yes, and any man that can ride on reindeer, he's definitely a bad dude, brother.
Yeah, he's, you know, he does so many, you know, dude, around the world, every children, one night, and at the same time, he's able to compile a list
of
every single thing that you do, good and bad.
And he can eat all them cookies and drink all that milk and not even gain a pound.
Well, you know,
he's been the same weight for about 500 years.
You know, I mean, when most people drink that much milk, they're either going to be constipated or they're going to have calcium deposits all over their face. But the density of his bones is on such an astronomical, super-duper, scoopaloopierilic level.
Mm-hmm.
You can't even touch that, you know what I mean? And so he has to drink this much milk in case of the horrible event. See, most people don't know, in the year of 1520, Santa Claus fell off of his sleigh over the Himalayas, broke his collarbone.
Yeah, I remember that.
Almost ruined Christmas if it wasn't for Blade and I able to sneak in. And we can't do it like him. It took two of us to do what he does. We were able to finish dropping off the presents that year to the children around the world. Now, this is why Santa Claus drinks so much milk. Because he needs that extra calcium, so if he was to ever fall off the sleigh again, he would simply bounce. His bones would not break.
Exactly. He's like a newborn baby where the bones could just bend like a straw but don't break.
Like Wolverine style.
Yes. And don't ask me to say what kind of bones Wolverine has, because I always get tongue-tied.
Yeah, well, it's Wolverine. Some things are better left unsaid, Fred.
Didn't they sing a song like, I'm too sexy for my,
Adamantium.
Bobsled? Yeah.
The president, what does he want?
He's still asking for his teeth. He said he's trying to eat a tube steak.
Oh, tell him to suck on it for a minute, get some flavor. And then, the tube steak has lost all the flavor from sucking, then his teeth should be there by then so he can nibble on it.
Okay. I'll let Nancy tell them.
Nice. So we're talking about Santa Claus, you know, and Santa Claus has got this army of elves, which is, you know, actually, the army of elves are actually Bad Dudes Junior recruits when they're really, really young. They just, you know, because they're so spiritual and magical, they've been dubbed elves throughout history.
Mm-hmm.
But it's actually just little Bad Dudes cadets that are only, you know, they're under 10 years old, so they're not that tall.
Yes, yes.
Thus, they look like elves.
Yes, and they're not that short either.
No.
I mean, Santa Claus is just about, 10 feet tall, so he makes him look kind of small.
He's a big guy, but he actually, you know, you talk about me being able to transform. Santa Claus is the man!
How does he fit down that chimney?
I don't know. He got his transformation down to some molecular level.
Molecular. Yeah, well, He's Kris Kringle, and he's Santa for a reason, brother.
Yeah, you know. And, you know, he's always rocking, hip-hopping, show-stopping.
Oopin' and boppin'.
Yeah, he keeps things up-tempo, you know what I mean?
Mm-hmm.
He keeps things up-tempo up there.
He's a jolly old fella.
Yeah. And, you know, he keeps things rocking around the Christmas tree.
Yeah, it sounds like a song, too.
Rocking around the Christmas tree at the Christmas party hop. Mistletoe hung where you can see, every couple tries to stop. Rocking around the Christmas tree, let the Christmas spirit ring. Later we'll have some pumpkin pie and we'll do some caroling. You will get a sentimental feeling when you hear voices singing, let's be jolly, deck the halls with boughs of holly. Rocking around the Christmas tree, have a happy holiday. Everyone dancing merrily in the new old-fashioned way.
You got a good singing there. It's a good singing voice there, brother.
Yeah, well, you know, I like it. I love Christmas music. There's something about Christmas music that just, you know, some people don't like it. It really gets
me. Oh, I love it.
But I think they're just, they you know, sometimes if you want to be a bad dude, you got to know when it's to let any type of coolness go. Because get in the holiday spirit. You know, a lot of people don't, they won't get into the holiday spirit, which I don't understand. Like, you know, loving your fellow man, being a little bit nicer.
Mm-hmm.
That stuff should be done all year round.
Exactly.
But,
exactly.
You know, you gotta facilitate that wave. You know what I mean? And so when the rest of the world around you is only gonna try to feel that way during Christmas time, you gotta help them push that wave over to the next year. And then hopefully, as a collective, if you can push more people, then they'll get the crabby cock-a-doodler dudes. To fill the Christmas spirit also.
Exactly. And those crabby cocklet doo-doo-doos, they're pretty smelly, too. Nobody wants to be around that.
You know, when you wish someone a Merry Christmas, you know, do it from your heart. Or if you wish someone a Happy Holidays, or whatever religion that, you know, you're all about in the holiday season, you wish someone a Merry Christmas or Happy Holidays, or, you know, Happy Hanukkah, Happy Kwanzaa, you know, you're only wishing someone the best. Do you know what I'm saying? Like, that's what I never understood. Like, you know, someone says, hey Stryker.
Yeah. Well, hey, Stryker.
They say to me, Happy Hanukkah. I don't celebrate Hanukkah, personally, but I'm most happy to receive that message from someone.
Mm-hmm.
You know, because to me, someone saying, Happy Hanukkah, Merry Christmas, Happy Kwanzaa, happy whatever.
Yes.
It's like them saying, hey, whatever I believe in, I'm asking that deity or whatever to send the best protection and wishes to your family during this time of year. How is that hurting anybody?
Not at all. That is
right?
That can make somebody's day.
Right. So, you know, I think people just, you know, just when somebody says something, you take it. to thank you, because you know what? That's the bad dude's way.
Mm-hmm.
You know? And our whole world is, you just say happy holidays. No, don't just say happy holidays. You know, say whatever. As long as it's in a positive, meaningful way. Like, what do you say?
I just say, I hope you and your family have a very Merry Christmas.
Yes. And you know what I say?
What was that? Broke
you know
up.
What I say?
What do you say? What I say?
Feliz Navidad.
I know what that means, but do everybody who's listening to this episode know what it means?
Of course, that's a Spanish word. And whenever we have a Spanish word here at the Bad Dudes, there's only one person to call to decipher Español.
The Spanish lady, or the Spanish robot lady. There you go, the Spanish robot lady.
Yes, or as I like to call her, Tutsi Frutsky.
The Spanish word of the podcast is Feliz Navidad. Feliz Navidad in English means, Jose, will you tell the listeners what Feliz Navidad in English means? Awesome. Here we go.
Feliz Navidad. Feliz Navidad. Feliz Navidad. Prospero año y felicidad. Feliz Navidad. Feliz Navidad. Feliz Navidad. Prospero año y felicidad. I want to wish you a Merry Christmas. I want to wish you a Merry Christmas. I want to wish you a Merry Christmas from the bottom of my heart. I want to wish you a Merry Christmas. I want to wish you a Merry Christmas. I want to wish you a Merry Christmas from the bottom of my heart. Feliz Navidad. Feliz Navidad. Feliz Navidad. Prospero año y felicidad. Feliz Navidad. Feliz Navidad. Feliz Navidad. Prospero año y felicidad. I want to wish you a Merry Christmas. I want to wish you a Merry Christmas. I want to wish you a Merry Christmas from the bottom of my heart. I want to wish you a Merry Christmas.
Navidad in English means Merry Christmas, and that's exactly what I want all of you to have. So behave, and be thankful for all the loved ones in your life.
You know, this year has been a really great year for the Bad Dudes. We decided to reveal who we are. We actually met two new recruits in Guija and JVB. And now we have this beautiful live cast that we can share our experiences with right. You beautiful people listening.
You know, we're able through this new medium to share our thoughts, our adventures. And, you know, Guija and JVB have done a great job. But, you know, we're really looking forward to coming into this next year with you guys. And, you know, we just want to take this time out of the live cast to just thank you guys very much for being listeners and listening to the Bad Dudes. And to let you know that this is just the beginning. We're not going anywhere.
exactly. And there should be plenty of bad dudes for the year 2011. Midway approached the bad dudes, Blade and Stryker, to be in a new Mortal Kombat. But Sub-Zero and Scorpion, they started to lobby against it, and they threatened to quit. So, to prevent any, and this hurts a little bit because I really wanted to be in there, but to prevent any bad blood, we just backed out because we love the Mortal Kombat series. Mm. Whoa, what's that, brother?
That was right there. That was the sound of us backing out.
Okay. Sounds like, I thought Centurion was in the house.
No, that was the sound that we made when we back out. Like bad dudes back out.
Okay.
Back out. But yeah, I just want to thank everybody. It's been an awesome year. You know, we hope you guys enjoyed it, and hope your family loves it. And I don't know. We're gonna keep things hype, man. It's the holiday season, and we wanna roll into next year with some cheer and the hilarities keep rolling, and yeah.
And laughter and raw. That's laughter.
Wow.
Yeah, scorpion juice and whatever. We're gonna have some new recipes too. Hey, speaking of recipes, are you gonna be cooking the mutton chops?
You know it, brother.
Those
extra blade style Scooby Dooby mutton chops with the hair and the scorpions and Sal Triumphant Jew, all that. It's all going to be in the mix.
Ooh, sounds tasty.
We're going to be partying. We're having a bad dudes party here. Everybody's going to be here. Rambo's coming. You know, we got Snake Eyes is going to be in the house. He-Man, Bandit Arms, all the homeboys from the old school, Master Chief's going to stop by.
I haven't seen John 117 in a while.
We got the Castle Crasher guys coming in.
Yes, I hope the Solid Snake, I hope he makes it.
Yes,
I gotta look around, see if there's a cardboard box in the corner, because he did that to us one time.
Spider-Man, Wolverine, all the old crew's gonna step up in the house, you know what I'm saying? Not Superman, Superman's still got, he's got problems against you, man. Super Mango will be here, though.
Yes, Super Mango, and hopefully things will iron out between me and the Man of Steel. I think he's just a little jealous at my awesome physique.
Well, I think you should. It's Christmas time. You know, Christmas time is the time of year to, you know, the people that, you know, you may have had to squabble, you got to say forgive them. Forgive and forget, right? Move on. Mm-hmm.
Yes, absolutely. I think I'm just going to take a trip to meet him. I know where he's at.
Well, you know what? This is what we're going to do. While you're going, give Superman a call right now. And while you make that call, this is a funky song. This is a... Oh, here's a Christmas song for the Bad Dudes listeners that's old and new. And this is what represents what the Bad Dudes all about.
Yeah.
It's new. It's what we're coming to in the future, which you guys really bring in. And old, which is what we bring, the old school knowledge of hip-hop and 80s and Bad Dudes and just mashing it together. I like that chicken.
Rah.
Santa Claus is coming to town. maybe what happened next was inevitable.
What would you like for Christmas?
Horrified, I heard myself blurt it out.
I want an official red rocker cover next to George Jones while Aaron.
No, shoot your eye out.
Started doing backspins and the worm.
So what happened? What happened with Superman?
Gave him a call. I apologized. He apologized as well. He actually said that he really missed arm wrestling with me because I'm one of the few people, and you being the other.
Right, that could actually handle him.
Exactly. So I apologize for the practical joke. I'm not going to say what it was, but let's just say that the Man of Steel is not truly the Man of Steel in every part of his body. Hey, what's so funny? I told him I wouldn't tell nobody that. Oops.
Oh, that's all right, dude. But what matters is now that we're all friends again, we can continue to save the universe as well as the galaxy.
Exactly.
And Nebula and the Trisferium Sanctraphelin.
Yes, absolutely.
So, before we go, Bad Dudes listeners, and end you off with this beautiful Christmas special, we want to read you guys a story and a poem that some Bad Dudes listeners may have heard before, some may not have.
Mm-hmm.
And this is a poem entitled, "'Twas the night before Christmas." And it goes something
like, classic.
Goes something like this. "'Twas the night before Christmas, when all through the North Pole, not a ninja was stirring, not even a highly techno-organic supervirus. The ammo was hung by the armory with care and hopes that some fool would try to rob St. Nicholas.
The elves were nestled all snug in their beds while visions of the Bad Dudes danced in their heads. And Blade in his kerchief and Stryker in his cap had just settled in their brains for a long winter snap.
When out from the lawn, there arose such a clatter. We sprung from our beds to see what was the matter. Away to the window we flew like a flash. Tore open the shutters with handguns in our hands.
The moon on the breast of the new fallen snow gave the luster of evil ninjas trying to steal Santa's show. When what to my wondering eyes should appear, Skeletor and Cobra Commander would suddenly appear.
With a high five we gave each other, so lively and quick, we knew in a moment it's butts we must kick. More rapid than eagles, we swooped in to fight. Skeletor whistled and shouted and called his minions by name.
Now, Dracula. Now, Beastman. Now, Storm Shadow and Venom. On Joker, on Sartan. On Darth Vader and Grievous. To the top of the porch. To the top of the wall. Fight then, bad dudes. Fight away. Ruin Christmas for all.
Like dry leaves that before the wild hurricane fly, when they meet with an obstacle mounted to the sky. So up to the housetop the bad dudes they flew, with the sleigh full of swords, and a new Jorgen too!
And then in a twinkling, the elves heard on the roof the crying and screaming of the ninjas aloof. As Jorgen drew his head, that was spinning around down the chimney, the Joker came with a bound.
He was all dressed in fur from his head to his foot, and his clothes were all tarnished with ashes and soot. A bundle of evil toys he flung on his back, and he looked like a clown opening his big sack.
Jorgen's eyes, how they twinkled with this new laser upgrade. His cheeks were like roses, his nose like a cherry. His droll little mouth was drawn like a bow. And a fat laser shot out and charred the Joker to black snow.
The stump of a pipe, Skeletor held tight in his teeth. And the smoke encircled his head like a wreath. He had a skeleton face and a little bitty belly that shook when he laughed like a bowl full of jelly.
He was skinny and bony, a right evil old wizard. And I laughed when I saw him in spite of myself. A wink of his eye and a twist of his head soon gave Stryker to know he had so much to dread.
He spoke not a word, but went straight to his work. And he flung towards Stryker as he turned with a jerk. And laying his finger aside of his nose, Stryker blasted him in the head. Up the chimney he rose.
Cobra Commander sprang to his sleigh. To his team he gave a whistle. And away they all flew like a dawn of thistle. But we heard his exclaim. Ere he drove out of sight, I'll get you next time, bad dudes. I'll put up a fight.
As Santa came out, it became quite clear. He was always glad that the bad dudes were there.
To save the day before Christmas night.
Have a merry Christmas all, and to all a good night. Merry Christmas, Barry Dids listeners.
Merry Christmas, brothers and sisters.
See you guys next year.
Ho, ho, ho. Wow.
Ho, ho, hoing. What do you think of Christmas if he's snowing? And people get their evil, hit the 411 for growing. You know it. We're blowing in the ghetto, they get nothing. No toys for little boys, no curls for girls, the turkey stuffing. They laugh. They know that half the presents ain't thick. You might just wanna ask her with my presents, ain't Nick? So think a little about the people minus money. And when you get your dough, why don't you show some kindness, honey? Go ahead, get fed, and spread a little love. Get what you can afford, just like the Lord from up above. A quote, a note, and one you won't believe. It's better to give than to receive. Yo!
Yeah, this is Sal again. You know, what kind of a world do we live in where, you know, someone that can literally teach Rodan Spanish and, you know, has tricked two of the baddest dudes on the planet to not only be the greatest heroes ever, but also run a fairly successful podcast. You know, how can someone like that wind up financially destitute? You know, it's unbelievable. I'm so angry. Feces and a bad sense of business has brought me to this. Let me some money.
What's going on, bad dudes? Blade, Stryker, Davey B. Gwijic. I want to wish you guys a safe and happy holiday. You know, it's me, Heroic Superman, or as Striker likes to call me, Super Mongo. I just want to wish you guys, you know, again, a happy holiday, safe holiday and all, to you and your family and all the listeners also. And looking forward to what you guys are going to be bringing up in 2011. Good job, guys. Keep up the good work, man. Hopefully you'll be enjoying the show. By the way, just in case anybody cares, seeing as that no one has called me or corresponded to me in any way, no email, not even snail mail, nothing, I'm living out of Triumph Mobile. That's right, I'm living out of the back of my 94 Jetta. Happy holidays.
Hello, Striker and Blade, it's old man Peabody. Listen, I really wanted to thank you for saving me from the ninjas. That was really great, but now I got this gay guy knocking at the door. He says his name is Krause, and he says he has cookies. I don't know, try sending him to JVP's house where he's got the yak butter waiting, I don't know. Anyway, Merry Christmas, Happy Hanukkah, Happy Kwanzaa, Happy Boxing Day, Happy Poop Day, Happy Yak Day, Happy Easter Goldfish Day, Happy Day. I need a drink.
Oh yeah, dig it. This is a macho man hanging out with Hollywood Hogan and Mighty Cyrus. We all screaming. Oh yeah. Oh yeah. Mighty over to the macho man. Oh yeah. Feel the madness, brother. Oh yeah. I'd like to wish everybody a merry, merry Chicken. Madness Christmas to all of you brothers out there. Oh, yeah.
Look at the chicken.
Hey, bad dudes. How's it going? This is Sal Triumphant. It's been a little while since we spoke. I'm not doing too good. Lost a lot of money in my little venture, my little poop venture. And, just recently, lost the apartment as well, believe it or not. I can still bench press trucks with one hand, and, you know, I can fly around the world 5 times in under a minute, but for some reason, that's just not enough for the landlords these days. Anyway, happy holidays. I'm glad somebody's having a good Christmas, because I sure as hell ain't. Also, if you guys can feed in your hearts to lend me a couple of bucks, just give me a call. Bye.
Now, for the first time ever, a collection of Snastly Quick's greatest holiday hits. Over 5 volumes of hit-by-hit classical holiday albums that's sure to help your family this holiday season. Such as this classic track.
Hey you, quit picking your nose. Santa Claus is watching, he's driving down the road. It might be kind of crusty, you gotta get it out. Santa Claus won't give you corn if you stick it in your mouth. Don't pick your nose, Santa Claus is watching.
Yes, they're all here. All of Snastly Quick's greatest holiday hits, including the brand new smash single, Hey Santa Claus, No More Ho Ho Ho's. Yo, Santa Claus, no more ho ho ho. Santa Claus, no more ho ho ho. Santa Claus, no more ho ho ho. What you mean, no more ho ho ho? What you mean, no more ho ho ho? What you mean, no more ho ho ho? Tell them why.
Because you eat too many ho-hos and you're driving around with hoes. So Santa Claus, we need you around because we love you a lot. Who eat so much, don't hang around them hoes. Santa Claus, no more ho-hos. Santa Claus, no more ho-ho-hos. Santa Claus, no more ho-ho-hos. Santa Claus, no more ho-ho-hos.
All is necessary for your favorite. Here for your family. The special bonus, the Sal Triumphant Comeback Song. Order now, all proceeds go to the Sal Triumphant. We love you. Come back to us, fun. Order at 1-900. Make it like a high, make a high knee ho. Do it now.
Yeah. Central, you're the connection, man. The level.